welcome delegates and special guests to the Registered Nurses Union's 25th Biennial Convention. We have an exciting week ahead of us. Our convention brings together registered nurses from across Newfoundland and Labrador to discuss our vision for a high-quality healthcare system, a vision that includes workplaces that value and respect registered nurses and our work. It's an opportunity to learn and to contribute, a chance to collaborate to determine how to support the RN profession and our province's healthcare system. Our theme this year is Registered Nurses, Vital to Your Health. Registered nurses in Newfoundland and Labrador are essential to healthcare. Whether you work in acute care, long-term care, community, education, or research, your value to the system is undeniable. Patients, clients, residents, families, and even entire communities depend on the expert care of registered nurses. As registered nurses, we recognize subtle changes in health status. We act on those changes and prevent health complications. We provide care for a wide range of patients, from the most stable to the most critically ill. We complete thorough assessments and use advanced judgment to make decisions. We educate, we teach, we complete and participate in nursing research. We are leaders, and most importantly, we save lives. That is our role in healthcare. Registered nursing is hard, challenging work, physically, mentally, and emotionally. But it's also meaningful and incredibly rewarding work. This week is about RN empowerment, ensuring you are equipped with the tools and support needed to succeed in your role. This week focuses on fighting for a system that supports you. It's about acknowledging what is vital to your health. This means removing the roadblocks and hurdles that prevent you from providing the safest, highest quality of care to your patients. Later today, we will shine a light on professional practice. Under our collective agreement, we have a professional practice complaint process. Registered nurses have a professional obligation to report issues or concerns with patient care. This could include delayed or incomplete or missed care, inadequate equipment or supplies, or inadequate staffing levels. RNU has made professional practice a top priority for our union. This is our best mechanism for creating better work environments, but it has to work correctly. That is why we have provided every member with a professional practice toolkit. Within the coming weeks, there will be education tools available to our members on our website. And there will be a focus on professional practice education at every RNU event. We need every RN in the province documenting professional practice issues and building the evidence for improvements in the workplace. We need to build our capacity at the professional practice committee level. It's crucial that every RN is engaged in this process. Now, this should not be an adversarial process. Registered nurses and employers should have the same objective. That is to provide safe, quality patient care to our patients. Yet many in this room expressed frustration around the timeliness of response to professional practice complaints, around inadequacy of the response when you get it, and the lack of urgency to resolve identified concerns. Sound familiar? This is unacceptable. It is unacceptable to registered nurses, it's unacceptable to our patients and our clients, and it should be unacceptable to employers. Yet, Almost daily, I hear story after story of registered nurses not being able to meet their standards of care, their standards of care being compromised. Well, our professional practice process needs teeth. We need accountability and stronger language on time limits. This includes the capacity to have an independent assessment, someone to review and facilitate a resolution when it can't otherwise be achieved at the professional practice committee level. Language with teeth, a process reinforced and enforced by an independent body. These must be priorities for RNU when we return to the bargaining table next year. This week, we will also highlight a growing concern in the nursing profession, post-traumatic stress disorder. PTSD affects registered nurses working on the front lines of healthcare. A researcher from the Manitoba Nurses Union will be here tomorrow to share their research on PTSD in nursing. We will talk about how the exposure to traumatic and critical incidents on a daily basis impacts the mental health of nurses. RNU is firmly committed to increasing awareness of PTSD amongst our members and amongst employers. In fact, tomorrow we have opened our session to employers and stakeholders to begin that education process. This presentation is the first step in an effort to achieve presumptive legislation for registered nurses. If passed, this legislation would recognize that PTSD can stem from an accumulation of events or experiences rather than having to pinpoint one specific trigger. On Thursday, you will debate a resolution which will provide direction to your board on this very important workplace concern. And I look forward to our discussion. Our week will also include the launch of tools that will help you as RNU leaders. I'm proud to say that our new RNU website goes live this week. It is fresh, modern, and user-friendly. And more importantly, it's mobile-friendly. So you can track the latest news and information directly on your mobile phone. And I'm also so excited that on Friday, we will launch the RNU app. Yay! It has all the features of our members-only website, including a planner, so you can track your shifts and your schedule. So when a member asks you about a collective agreement article, now you'll be able to say, there's an app for that. And you can get your member to download the RNU app so they have the latest information available right with them on their mobile device. We're only the second nurses union in Canada to have an app. And these improvements will hold great potential for us to enhance our connections with our members. We also are continuing our positive work through the Clarity Project. Together, we have given registered nurses a strong and unique professional identity. We've been introducing ourselves as registered nurses and wearing our white and black RN uniform colors to stand out in the healthcare system. I just think it's amazing and exciting that about 75% of registered nurses have adopted the uniform colors of the registered nurse. What a testament to your determination, your commitment, your leaders, because I know many of you are Clarity Project ambassadors, and registered nurses' pride in our profession. Through Clarity, we have built a better understanding of the distinct value registered nurses contribute to healthcare. Our patients, clients, residents, and their families have a better understanding of who the RN is and what our role means to them and to the system. Our media campaign, registered nurses, nursing to a higher level, brought out our education, our in-depth knowledge, advanced critical thinking, and problem solving to the forefront. And the public listened. They have a greater understanding of the RN role and that registered nurses are vital to their health. Today, though, even as we celebrate our successes of Clarity and our research and our new app, I'm also very aware of the daily challenges that you face in your workplace. The dangerously long shifts of 16, 20, and 24 hours. Working short, heavy workloads that are near impossible to maintain. We know the healthcare system is on thin ice, and we're reaching a dangerous tipping point. Our healthcare system needs more support, right at a time when our province is in the midst of an economic downturn. We acknowledge the severity of the fiscal situation, but fixing healthcare has to be part of the solution. Registered nurses are a leading voice and a leading force for change. We are the largest group of healthcare professionals. The public trusts registered nurses the most when it comes to healthcare. When we speak, the public trusts us. And we, as a union, RNU values this public trust. We are committed to helping create a strong, sustainable healthcare system, but not at the expense of quality patient care, and certainly not at the expense of the health of registered nurses. I have an interesting quote for you that reflects our position. Healthcare cannot be tied to the price of oil. When you enter an emergency room, your first question shouldn't be, what's the price of oil? What we need to do is spend more wisely. We need to manage our resources carefully. There are significant opportunities in human resource planning that requires innovation, particularly in healthcare. These are the words of Premier Dwight Ball speaking at our RNU election panel 1 year ago. The Premier also stated, and I quote, "It is a priority for us to work with your group to improve the lives of registered nurses. No matter where I go, I have many friends that work in healthcare, and they're telling me about how desperate things would be, about working extended shifts, 24 hours on call. So we need to deliver healthcare in a better way that we can help alleviate that pressure." End of quote. Premier, I couldn't agree more. And Premier, registered nurses are going to hold you to those words. We have always been vocal on behalf of our members, and we will continue to do so. In the last year, whether it was behind the scenes or in the public domain, we have placed ourselves at every table and every opportunity where healthcare was being discussed. We lobbied for and achieved a full-day meeting with the regional health authorities and Department of Health and Community Services officials to discuss RN staffing and improvement in the workplace. When the provincial government launched their government renewal initiative earlier this year, we put forward the solutions of registered nurses. We met with the health minister, we met with the finance minister, and we met with the premier to present research on how appropriate RN staffing has a positive impact on healthcare delivery, patient outcomes, and guess what, can even save money. Just yesterday, as I mentioned earlier, your board met with the Minister of Health and Community Services to once again discuss these very same issues. This past year, we stood alongside our labor and community partners through the Common Front NL to share our vision for the future. We spoke out against the cuts made in the provincial government brought down earlier this year. We rallied, we attended town halls, we participated in press conference, planning meetings, and strategy sessions. Collectively, we applied pressure, and successfully, we backed government off many of their regressive initiatives and their planned mini-budget set for this fall. Tomorrow, Mary Shortle, President of the Federation of Labor, will be with us to share more on this important coalition and because our work is not done. On Thursday, government will release their mid-year fiscal update. I am sure it will paint a bleak picture. So we must keep the pressure on. 2 weeks ago, I attended a government consultation session that they called The Way Forward. Well, while I'm encouraged that there looks like they're going to implement a couple of initiatives that were RNU's The Way Forward, like initiatives on primary health care and midwifery legislation, as I said to the Premier at that session, when are we going to talk about the day-to-day issues in the healthcare system that have to be addressed? If government honestly intends to move forward, then they must address the challenges RNs face every day in the workplace. For example, as our board asked the Minister of Health yesterday, when are we going to seriously tackle the very real issue of violence in the workplace? I don't have to tell you that nursing is one of the most dangerous professions. In fact, a nurse has a greater chance of being assaulted than a prison guard. And I'm sure every single one of you have an experience you can share. Just a few weeks ago, at one of our work sites, our members and other providers were put in a very dangerous position when a patient lashed out. Staff were fearful for their safety and for the safety of their patients. Assaults occurred. This is not acceptable. This is not part of our job. I was looking on Twitter last night and I saw a report come out of Ontario where a registered nurse in Ontario was assaulted on Sunday. She was beaten by a patient. She was dragged into a utility room and kicked in the head, and only for the fact that another staff member witnessed it and called for help, she could have died. As it is, she has serious injuries and may lose her sight or some of her sight forever. This is not part of our job. We shouldn't have to face these situations. When we go to work in the morning, we shouldn't be concerned we're going to end our shift in an emergency room. More needs to be done to keep people safe in our workplaces. We have advocated over and over for a provincial strategy to address workplace violence. So far, with no success. However, our counterparts in Manitoba and New Brunswick are implementing innovative strategies. Only last week, the Premier of Nova Scotia and the President of the Nova Scotia Nurses Union announced their violence prevention plan at a joint press conference. Well, it's time for a Newfoundland and Labrador plan. We need enhanced security measures, public education, better communication, and enforceable, and I mean enforceable, zero tolerance policies. Violence is not acceptable and cannot be part of our job. When are we going to focus on real strategies that improve the system rather than inefficient non-solutions that don't work for registered nurses and our patients? We've been relying on what I call duct tape solutions for too long. Duct tape solutions like agency nurses. In Labrador, the recruitment and retention of registered nurses is not working. Instead, costly agency RNs are being used to fill vacancies and provide relief. I can only guess how much that is costing the system. Duct tape solutions like requiring mandatory overtime to address staffing shortfalls. Duct tape solutions like choosing not to replace like with like. It takes a team of healthcare professionals to provide quality patient care, and each role is important. But if I might again quote Premier Ball one more time, healthcare professionals, RNs, are not interchangeable. You cannot just move one healthcare professional out and expect that you can replace it with someone that has a different skill set. Someone who has different training would not have the expertise. End of quote. Our position exactly, Premier Ball. Duct tape solutions like not replacing the first sick call and forcing RNs to work short-staffed. This leads to high rates of absenteeism, high sick leave, and burnout. And that's a dangerous cycle. In 2014 and 15, governments spent $14.5 million in overtime just for registered nurses alone. They spent $33.5 million in RN sick leave and relief. Can you imagine how these millions of dollars could be used to improve healthcare and our workplaces, rather than continuing to understaff us, overwork us, and make us sick? Based on these numbers and the experiences of registered nurses, we can't afford to do nothing. We can no longer ignore the state of our healthcare system. Duct tape is no longer acceptable. RNU is willing to partner with the government and employers in building a sustainable healthcare system, but it has to be a system that supports and values our work and provides quality, safe care to our patients. This week, we will be asking delegates to support your board's call for government to complete a core staffing review. We need to send a strong message to government that this is a priority, not just for the RNU Board of Directors, but a strong priority for every single RN in this province. A core staffing review would examine the number and type of healthcare providers who are currently working in the system. The last review was done in this province in the late 1990s. Since then, we have seen increases in patient acuity, complexity, shorter hospital stays, and advances in diagnostics and treatments. Demands have gone up, but staffing levels have not kept up with demand. We need to develop tools that allow us to use patient data to determine whether or not we have the right number of people to provide care. Staffing should not be based on a line on a budget. Staffing should be based on patient care needs. Earlier this year, I had the opportunity to study an innovative model of nurse staffing in New Zealand. I was impressed and excited by the promise it holds. This model is data-driven, it uses the latest technology, it is responsive to changes in patient condition, and more importantly, it is based on the assessments of frontline nurses. It works on the principles of patient acuity rather than just patient numbers. As one RN said to me, we staff based on the care required of the actual patient in the bed, not based on the number of beds. Just think about that. To actually consider patient acuity and patient needs in a staffing model. Imagine how empowering this would be for registered nurses. There are better ways, and they're out there. We expect Premier Ball to be true to his word, to work with us, to work with registered nurses, to work with RNU. Commit to creating a healthcare system that supports registered nurses and supports our vital work. A system that can meet the needs of the public now and into the future. Tomorrow, we will rally. Can't wait. We will rally to collectively send a message to government that the time of duct tape solutions is over. And that's going to be our message tomorrow as we rally outside of Central Health, a message to government, no more duct tape. We want real solutions that will help RNs work, do our work within the workplaces of this province. I want to end by talking about collective bargaining. A big success for RNs this year was our contract extension, keeping our collective agreement in place until June 30th, 2017. This was a deliberate, strategic move by your board of directors. Unlike government, we don't make strategic mistakes. Close your ears, Beth. This decision sent a strong message to government that RNU is a force to be reckoned with. And when Minister Bennett called me and asked us to go to the table anyway, well, I just politely declined that invitation. But we know challenging times are coming. Like you, we've heard the rumors, clawbacks, wage freezes, benefit reductions, and so on. Could they really expect RNs to do more with less, for less? I'm telling government today that that's not up for negotiation. I'm telling government that our way forward is not to go backwards. And this is not Debbie Forward's position. This is not just me talking up here this morning. This is our emphatic position of registered nurses. Our research is clear. Our members are not prepared to negotiate wage rollbacks or a slash and burn of our benefits. That is clear. Now, we can't talk about bargaining without mentioning budget 2017. And let me be clear, again, as we head into the next budget, reducing healthcare costs by cutting registered nurse positions is also not the way forward. This is not on for registered nurses. And it's also not on for the people of Newfoundland and Labrador. In fact, in our most recent survey, 94% of the people in our province are opposed to government eliminating registered nurse positions as a cost-saving measure. 94% of the people of this province stand with registered nurses on this issue. Do not cut RN positions. So today, I'm drawing not one, but two lines in the sand. First, RNU will fight any reduction of RN positions that will have a negative impact on the people we care for or a negative impact on the health and safety of our members. Second, RNU will fight any attempt by government to impose a collective agreement that will force RNs to work with less, for less. And just in case that message isn't clear enough, wage rollbacks or slash and burn if our benefits are not on. So how will we do this? Well, as we've always done this, we will do it by doing what we do best, standing together, not just with each other, but with the people of our province. We did it in 1999. We did it again in 2008. And we have fought many, many battles together in between. I am ready for our next fight, and I know you are ready too. Together, we will achieve. Thank you.
No!